نحمده ونسلي ونسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد رسوله النبي الأمين المكين الحنين الكريم الرؤوف الرحيم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين صدق الله العظيم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم Dear viewers, I welcome you to another episode of the Friends of Almighty Allah, a program that is devised on the platform of ARY Qtv to discuss the life and the teachings of the Friends of Allah, those that are for us the best guides after the messengers, after the prophets of Almighty Allah, those that are known as the Awliya Allah. Alhamdulillah, in our previous episode, we have discussed some aspects of the life of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, the great distinguished Sufi of his time, friend of Almighty Allah of his time, who was known for his piety, who was known for his taqwa, who was known for his steadfastness, for his istiqama, and who was known for his khawf, for the fearness of Almighty Allah that he possessed in his heart. And most importantly, who was known for the muhabba, for the love of Almighty Allah that was filled within his heart. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, dear viewers, is that person that another contemporary friend of Allah of his time, Hazrat Sarri Saqati rahmatullahi alayhi, said in regards to Maruf Karkhi that would it not be for Maruf Karkhi and would I not have been in the company of Maruf Karkhi, then I would never have attained spiritual excellence. I would never have attained the nearness of Almighty Allah. And it is Maruf Karkhi who taught me. It is Maruf Karkhi who educated me on the path of spiritual enlightenment. He is the one who enlightened me, who educated me, who created in me awareness how one can attain and achieve the nearness of Almighty Allah. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, dear viewers, was once asked by his friends, what is it that is the reason why you detach yourself from the dunya? What is it that has caused you to abstain from this dunya and this world and the creation of Allah Almighty? You were not bothered with it. And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi then was asked that, is it because you prolong and you wish and desire for the paradise and all the favors and the bounties of Almighty Allah that He has prepared for His servants in the paradise? Or is it because you are afraid of hell? You are afraid of the punishments in the hereafter. And that is the motive. That is the reason behind your detachment from the world and the dunya. And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi smiled back at the question, smiled at his friends, and he said, oh my friends, you are very silly, because these things, they are nothing in front of Almighty Allah. These things in front of Allah Almighty have no meaning. You discuss minor things. You discuss that is humble subjects in front of Almighty Allah. And he says, Maruf Karkhi does not worship Allah, has not become an obedient slave of Allah, and does not remain steadfastness on the path of the ibadah of Almighty Allah, and has not detached himself from the dunya, and has not taken out the world from his heart, because he prolongs to the paradise. He wishes to have Jannah and the bounties in Jannah, or he wishes to be saved from the eternal punishment. He says, no, the reason why Maruf Karkhi worships Allah and Maruf Karkhi is living such a life, he says, is because Maruf Karkhi has tasted the nearness of Allah, and Maruf Karkhi wants to remain always in the qurba of Almighty Allah. He always wants to be in the nearness of Almighty Allah. And he says, once you taste that pleasure, oh my friends, once you have tasted the pleasure of ibadah, the pleasure of being in the company of Almighty Allah, then Wallahi, nothing in this world will give you the same pleasure. Then you will always continuously to look after, to look for that pleasure. And this is the reason why Maruf Karkhi is living such a life. Dear viewers, there are numerous instances of karamat, miracles, that are attributed to this great friend of Almighty Allah, Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And one of these is that once there was a bandit who was captured by the governor and sentenced to being hanged. As per the command of the governor, he was hanged. And then his body was still hanging from the noose when Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi passed by. When he saw the scene of the body of that bandit that is now hanging from the noose, Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala became extremely upset, and his heart was filled with the fairness of Almighty Allah, but at the same time his heart was filled with compassion towards this person who was hanging from the noose. And Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi raised his hands, thinking, visualizing about the punishments in the hereafter that are waiting for this bandit. And Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi then says, Ya Allah, forgive this man. And if you want to take all my good deeds that I have done, take these good deeds and give them to this person who is hanging from the noose. Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi was so sincere, my dear viewers, that he was so sincere, he was willing to give up that is the most valuable, that what is only beneficial in the hereafter. Every single other thing, every wealth, everything from this dunya, every worldly thing is going to remain in this dunya, and one will not take away with him. The only thing that we take away with us is our a'mal, is our actions, is our good deeds, is our hasanat. And these are the ones that when we see them on the day of judgment, we will wish that, Ya Allah, we wish that we are given the time and the chance again to go back to dunya, so we could have spent more time, more effort in your ibadah, more effort, Ya Allah, for you. But that time, of course, at that time, you will not be given that chance. So the most valuable thing indeed is not these worldly things that will remain in the dunya, is that what we will take with us in the hereafter, and that is our hasanat. And Maruf Karkhi was a true friend of Allah. Maruf Karkhi was a true saint of Almighty Allah, true Sufi, one that looks at the creation of Allah and that is in difficulty, and he puts himself in difficulty just to bring that creation of Allah, bring others out of difficulty. He takes the burden from the shoulders of other creation of Almighty Allah, other servants of Almighty Allah, and he puts those burdens on their own shoulders. Maruf Karkhi made the dua, Ya Allah, whatever I have done until today, I ask you to give the reward to this man who is hanging from the noose. Then when he was completed the dua, a voice was being heard which said, O Maruf, this person has been given forgiveness, has been granted forgiveness. But not only this, because of your sincerity, because of your dedication, because of your love, and because of the way you look after the creation of Almighty Allah, I am rewarding you, Maruf, that whoever attends the funeral, the janazah of this man who is hanging on the noose, this bandit, every single person that attends the janazah will be forgiven also. Dear viewers, this is because of the true dedication and the love and the sincerity, the selflessness of a friend of Allah, that Allah Almighty looked at his servant and saw that he, being his servant, being his creation, gives up everything that he has, everything that he owns, and looks at the kindness and the compassion of his servant Maruf Karkhi. And then Allah Almighty says, O Maruf, you are my servant. If you can be this compassionate, this kind, then my compassion and kindness is beyond your imagination. So this is why Allah Almighty then said, through the voice of the angel which was heard, that, O Maruf, anyone who will attend the janazah of this person, he also will be forgiven, not only the bandit, but everyone that will attend the janazah of this bandit. Almighty Allah had accepted the prayer of Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, and through the prayer of Maruf Karkhi, he had forgiven all those that attended the janazah of this bandit. Such is the muqam, dear viewers, of the friends of Allah. Such is the status of the friends of Allah. And this status cannot be achieved by just the ibadah of Allah, until a person becomes selfless, until a person becomes devoted to the creation of Allah, and he has extreme love for the creation of Allah, and because of that love, he now is not selfish, he is selfless, and he is willing to give up anything just for the sake of the creation of Allah. This is the time when a person becomes the friends of Allah. All those people that believe that by worshipping and by ibadah they can attain the nearness of Allah, they should realize that if that ibadah is not accompanied by akhlaq, if that ibadah is not accompanied by looking after the creation, by love for the creation, then that ibadah of yours will only tick the boxes. They will only tick the boxes, but you will not attain the nearness of Almighty Allah. If you want the nearness of Almighty Allah, you need to accompany the ibadah with husni mu'amalat, with beautiful attitude and behavior towards the creation of Almighty Allah. Once, Hazrat Maruf Karkhi, the same great Sufi, was sitting on a ferry, on a boat, with some of his associates. And while at the same time there were some non-believers, there were some non-Muslims that were there enjoying and having a party. They were entertaining themselves with wine and they were dancing. While Hazrat Maruf Karkhi was sitting in the same boat, they saw him, but despite that, they continued with their own actions. And one of the disciples came to Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi and said that, Oh Shaykh, please ask Almighty Allah to punish these people. Ask Almighty Allah to drown these people, since they have no respect and they have no adab for you, oh Shaykh. And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi then replied back, let us then raise our hands. And all the associates raised their hands, and Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi then said, Ya Allah, the way you have kept these people happy, the way they are happy now, Ya Allah, keep them happy similarly, the same way in the hereafter. The associates were astonished. Ya Shaykh, what have you asked? What have you done? And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala replied that, do you not understand? I asked Allah that, Allah, keep them happy in the hereafter, let them enjoy in the hereafter. But for them to enjoy in the hereafter, of course they will have to become believers. They first have to become believers and repent to Almighty Allah. And the dua, when Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullah alayhi completed the dua and he replied back to his associate who was questioning his dua, at the same spot, these people that were drinking, that were partying, suddenly smashed all their bottles of wines and threw some of them in the sea, and then came to the court of Maruf Karkhi and said, oh Maruf, we would like to accept Islam because we just heard you saying something that has made and have had an impact on us. That how could you be so kind? How could you be so generous? How could you be so loving towards us while we did not even take into consideration that in your religion you do not drink wine, and we in front of you kept drinking while it was the month of Ramadan. We did not value that, but despite that your attitude was so nice and kind that you prayed for us. And they said, this can only be done by a friend of Allah, by a saint, by someone who is truly representing Almighty Allah. And they, because of this, accepted Islam. So Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi's duas, they were accepted by Almighty Allah. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi passed on a Friday, which is the 2nd of Muharram in the year 200 of Hijri. His shrine is in the city of Baghdad. Hazrat Sirri Saqati rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, in regards to this great friend of Allah, whose life is for us an example, that we, while we are living in this day and age, while a lot of us have hatred for not only those that are not Muslims, but also for those that have a different interpretation of Islam, a different ideology, a different interpretation and understanding of our deen. We dislike them, we hate them. The friends of Allah are those whose hearts are not even filled with the hatred against those that do shirk and openly commit sin. They are even towards them, they are kind. They pray for their guidance. They pray for them, my dear viewers. And this is why we need to go back in this day and age, and we need to look at the life of these awliya Allah. Because they are the ones, if we follow them, and they truly are the ones who are following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are the ones that are actually following the Messenger of Almighty Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And this is why we need to look into their lives. And if we love them, if we claim to love them, then at least the least thing we can do is to accept and is to acknowledge and then to try to practice upon their teachings when it comes to loving the creation of Almighty Allah. Hazrat Sarri Saqati rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says in regards to the muqam of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi alayhi, he says that if anyone is facing any difficulty, if anyone is facing any challenge, any turbulence, any trial in their life, and they have prayed to Almighty Allah, and Allah Almighty has not accepted their prayers and has not removed the turbulence, the difficulty and the challenge in the life, then they must go to the shrine of Maruf Karkhi. And while they are standing at the shrine of Maruf Karkhi, there they must ask Almighty Allah through the wasila, through the sadaqah, through the means of Maruf Karkhi. And surely all your problems then will be solved, because he is such a wasila, he is a friend of Allah, he is such a means that Allah Almighty will not ignore your prayers, he will accept your prayers. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi's teachings, what are the teachings of this great friend of Allah? He said that he who trusts in Allah, he who trusts in God, remains secure from the evils of the people. Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi said that rather than entrusting your affairs to the dunya, entrusting your affairs to the worldly, therefore you should entrust your affairs into the hands of Almighty Allah. And when you will do so, you will be freed from the evil of the people. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi said, a true servant of God is a God-intoxicated saint who sees nothing except of his beloved. He says, a true servant of Allah, a true friend of Allah, is the one who does not look into anything else, who does not look for anything else except of his beloved. When he dresses, he doesn't dress for the people. When he talks, he doesn't talk for the people. When he gives a nasiha, he doesn't give nasiha for the people. He doesn't give because he wants something in return from them. When he does a good deed, he doesn't do this for the sake of the people. Everything that he does, he takes into consideration his Almighty Lord, Allah Almighty. He looks only at the pleasure of Almighty Allah, and he sees nothing except of his beloved Almighty Allah. That is a friend of Allah. And he says that when a believer occupies himself with things that do not concern him, it is a sign of God's wrath upon him. And when a person starts discussing, starts associating, starts always being curious about those things that are not really not concerning him, those things that do not concern him, and he tries to be nosy, he tries to be curious and he is nosy and tries to look after the affairs of other people, this is something Maruf Karkhi rahmatullah alayhi said, that it is a sign that Allah's wrath is upon you. Dear viewers, Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, throughout his life, was a practical example of someone who loved not only Allah Almighty but also the creation of Almighty Allah. And this is an important sign, an important quality of the true friends of Almighty Allah, that they will not just love Allah Almighty, similarly their love for the creation will be immense, because in the creation they see the beauty of Almighty Allah. The creation reminds them of the Creator. This is why they not only look after their ibadah, they not only spend time in worshipping Almighty Allah, they also divide their time into fulfilling the rights of the creation of Almighty Allah, the haqooqul ibad. The friends of Allah Almighty are those that do not detach themselves from the dunya completely and seclude themselves in caves, seclude themselves in jungles, and there continue to survive and live a life of seclusion. The friends of Allah are those, in fact, that live with the people, among the people. And while they are living among the people, their heart is filled with the love of Allah and the love of the creation of Allah. They do not have any love for the worldly things, for the materialistic things, but their love heart is filled with the love of Almighty Allah and the creation of Allah. And this is why they take extra care into looking after the needs of the people. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, as per the advice given to his Shaykh Ibn Simak, he used to love the poor people. He used to have food, sit with the poor people. And this is also why Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi was later forgiven by Almighty Allah. According to a dream that was seen by one of his disciples. Dear viewers, we ask Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us on the straight path, the path of those people upon whom Allah has bestowed his blessings. Until the next week, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.